let us begin a second video. Now, before we start the second video, I want to ask you questions, right? Because I need to know whether you are listening to my video or not. So, I need to ask you some questions. Now, my first question is, what work was Greg doing? What work was Greg doing? What was his job? That is my first question. My second question. What did Greg turn into when he was in his anxious dream? What did he see? He changed into what? That is my second question. Okay. Now let's continue with our lesson. And this is a very interesting story, right? When you keep listening to the story, you read the story, it is very, very interesting. Now let us see what happened to Greg, because he sees that he's changed into a bug, right? So let us see whether he can wake up from the dream or not. Okay. This lesson is on page 30, 31, right? Page 30, chapter 4, The Strange Transformation. So we are on page 31 now. Okay. Now, he says that, what did he say? Let me sleep for a while so that I can pass off this foolishness and I can forget this foolishness, this foolish dream, he told himself. But this was entirely impractical. This was entirely impractical. Impractical means something what is not into reality. Practical means we say, no, come on, let's be practical. We need to go to school. We need to have our food on time. We can't stay hungry. Can you say, okay, I'm going to just survive on air. I'm not going to eat food for 5 days. Is it practical? Can you stay 5 days on air, like love and fresh air? No, it is not practical. It is impractical to stay without food for 5 days, right? So, practical means something what we can do. And impractical is some weird idea what we get, which is not possible. So, now he's thinking he was trying to have some sleep. But now he thinks that it is entirely impractical. For he was used to sleeping on his right side. And in his present state, he couldn't get himself into this position. Now, he was turned into a big monstrous bug, right? So, now some of us have the habit, if we turn to the left side, we will get sleep. Sometimes we are turning this side, that side, we are sleeping on our back. But some people do have this habit that only if they turn to their left side, they will fall asleep. They can fall asleep faster. I don't know how many of you all have this habit. How many of you all have this habit to sleep on one side? Some people or some children especially, they sleep on their tummy. Means the back facing the sky. How many of you have this habit? Some children, they cannot sleep. So what the mother does is, she will put the baby sleeping on the tummy on the bed. Okay, and the mother will just tap the back so that the child will fall asleep. How many of you have said, if you'll have some younger brothers and sisters, you will know this. Probably, you know, sometimes sleeping on the tummy helps some air bubbles, you know, sometimes you cannot sleep, you feel discomfort. So when you sleep on your tummy, it helps you, you know, your stomach, it helps, the air bubbles might pass off. That could be one of the idea. And you get your sleep faster when you touch the bed on your tummy. Some people have this notion that when you sleep on your tummy, you will fall asleep faster. Especially when you don't get sleep, you try this. You can fall asleep faster. Okay, so now this Greg Samsa also had a habit of sleeping one side. But now due to the change, what happened that he turned into a huge monstrous bug, he's not able to turn on the side. He's on his back like that. He's not able to turn on his side. So he is not getting sleep. Now, and in this present state, he couldn't get himself into this position. Now, he was huge, right? He wants to turn on the right hand side. But he's not able to turn because it is not happening. As he was huge. No matter how hard he threw himself, into the right side. He always rolled back into his back. So probably now he is turned into a bug, right? And the huge tummy like that, which is round like a balloon. So when he's trying to turn around on the right side, he comes rolling back again in the same position, which is the right hand side. Sorry, it's on his back. He comes rolling back in the same position. So it's not able to happen that he is getting back on the right hand side. It's becoming very difficult for him. So he tried very hard, but he was getting back in the same position. He was rolling back. He must have tried it 100 times, closing his eyes so that he could not have to see the wriggling legs, and give up only when he began to feel a light. And he gave up only when he began to feel a light, dull pain in his side, which he never felt before. So he wanted to sleep. Why? Because he didn't want to see his feet, like legs wriggling and all that stuff. You know, he was feeling very uneasy. So he thought he would just sleep and let the dream pass off. So he didn't want to see his wriggling legs. What is wriggling? Twisting and turning. That is wriggling, right? Worms wriggle, right? So wriggling legs. He wanted to just close his eyes and have a sleep so that he could feel better. But he tried 100 times so that he could turn towards his right, but it was not getting possible. And he started feeling light pain. He says that it was a light, dull pain on his side, which he had never felt before. So when he was trying to turn and falling back, he started feeling the pain on his right side. A dull pain, you know, a dull pain is like, it is not, really very extensive pain, but a very mild pain, which you feel, you know, sometimes you feel, you say, I don't know, my hand is paining, I feel like that. So a light pain, a dull pain, which was like coming to his right side, which he had never felt before. Oh God, he thought, what a demanding job I've chosen. So now, as he's trying to sleep and he's not able to sleep also, so his thoughts are wandering. Now he's thinking about his job. Okay. He says, what a demanding job I've chosen, day in, day out on the road. He was a salesman, traveling salesman. So he had to always be on the move. So day in, day out, all the time he was traveling. The stresses of trade are much greater than the work going on at the head office. And in addition to that, I have to deal with the problems of traveling, the worries about the train connections, irregular food habits, temporary and constantly changing human relationships, which never come from the heart. So now he is describing about his job. What is he saying? Now he says that his job is so hectic. It's always like on the move. He cannot remain at home, like work from home. No, it's not like that. He need to go outside. Otherwise, his job was not completing. So he said, what a hectic and demanding job I have. He says he has to deal with the stress of trade, right? Because he was selling material. And he says that the trade are much greater than the work going on in the office. So he says that his job is more stressing and more demanding than the people just sitting in the office and working. Sitting job is not so demanding, right? Here he says that he has to worry about different things. People sitting in the office, they're just sitting in the office in the shelter. But I have to think about so many things, he says. He says, I have to think about traveling, waking up early, running, catching the train on time. And then when I have to go to a different place, like, you know, I have to see that the connecting train is, I'm on time so that I could be able to catch the connecting train. So connections of the trains, he was worried about. At one point of time, people who are traveling, they know that when they are traveling to a different place and when there is no straight train, they have to stop by at a junction and then we have to catch another train. He had to worry about the food habits. He was not getting regular food, right? They were in the train, they were traveling. So always the food, whatever they get in the middle in the traveling, they could eat, right? So irregular, bad food. So sometimes when we're traveling, we just eat, we keep snacking, we keep eating, which is also not very good habit all the time. Once in a way you snack, you eat, it's okay. But every day if you keep snacking, you keep eating, the habit has to be regular. Otherwise, it will affect your body. Now, temporary and constantly changing human relationships, which never came from the heart. Now he's saying that he met so many people, right? He was a salesman and he met so many people. He dealt with so many people. So there were so many people who were just so fake. They were not real. Like their friendship also was not real. They used to just give a fake smile. What is a fake smile? A fake relationship. You just meet, okay, hi, huh? Okay, I'm coming, huh? Bye, huh? Hi-bye relationships, what we call. Right? We call them hi-bye relationship or fake. Fake means something what is not real. Real relationships are what we have at home. Our parents, our siblings, our grandparents, our relatives. These are just fake relationships. You meet today, I deal some, make some business with you, I'm gone. Oh, next time when I meet you, okay, hi, what happened, how are you? So people are not, like they don't talk from the heart. Even if they say something, okay, you can read their smile. We can tell that, you know, see, this person is giving a fake smile. People talk to you genuinely with feelings, you will come to know. And people who just talk to you for namesake, you will come to know. Okay. So he said that these people are so fake. They don't have any feelings for anybody. They just talk to you because for sake of it. So the relationships are not coming from heart. To hell with all. He says to hell with all means I don't care. Damn it. I don't care about it now. He felt a slight itching on the top of his abdomen. Now he felt a slight itching. Again, you remember in the beginning of the lesson also, we spoke about the abdomen. So now he's saying he felt a slight itching. Yeah, itching is a slight irritation. So sometimes we say, no, my arm is itching. Okay, let me scratch a little bit like that and it'll pass off. It's itching. So it was itching on the top of his abdomen. So where is the abdomen? Abdomen is the part what is below the navel. You have the navel, right? What we call in Malayalam, nabi, right? So the area below the navel point is called abdomen. Okay. He slowly pushed himself on his back closer to the bed post so that he could lift his head more easily. Found the itchy part. Okay, so he tried to push himself on the bed, his body on the bed so that he could lift his head up and he could see his abdomen. Right, he could see his stomach. When we sleep straight, can we see our stomach? If we have a flat stomach, it's okay. Now we are kids, so it's okay. But can we see? We can see. But people who have a little tummy, you know, the stomach is a little projecting outside, the tummy. It is a little difficult for them to see their body, see their legs. When they're sleeping, they need to lift this part of the head and see, you know. Okay, something is on my legs, some mosquito is there, something is sitting on my stomach. So they need to raise their head and see because they are not able to see because the stomach is a little projecting. So they need to raise their head. Okay, he lifted his head more easily, found the itchy part. Now he had to see something was itching, it was something probably was irritating him. So he had to lift up his head and see, which was entirely covered with small white spots. He did not know what to make of them and tried to feel the place with his leg. But he retracted it immediately for the contact felt like a cold shower all over him. Now, what is he saying? he felt that something was itchy. So his hand probably, now since he's a bug, they have legs, right? We don't say hands of a mosquito or a bug. We say legs. So he tried to maybe just touch or just scratch or something. But then he found, what did he find? That the entire the area was covered up with white spots. Okay. And then he tried to feel the place with his leg. Right. But he retracted it immediately. Retract to pull off. Okay. He was touching that area of his stomach. But he just pulled off his hand. Because why? He felt that it was like a cold shower all over him. So he felt that watery sensation, you know, that cold water. Probably it was damp, the area was damp probably, and he found like it was like cold, the cold shower. So the droplets of the water was there. So he felt it like that all over him. He slid back again into his earlier position. So now he felt this. So he got back to the earlier position, the way he was sleeping. This getting up early, he thought, makes a man quite idiotic. Now, he had to wake up early because he had to travel, right? Sometimes he had to wake up more early, like maybe 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, since probably he had to be somewhere else on time, like 8 o'clock. So, he had to catch a bus or a train or something. So, he had to travel, right? Like, for example, some people work, suppose if you're staying in, for example, Koilandi or Vadakara or something like that. So, you have to wake up early. Suppose the school starts at 8:30. Can you wake up at 8 o'clock? Or can you wake up at 7 o'clock? Some of us who are living close by will wake up at 6:30, 7 o'clock, brush our teeth, take shower. Okay, 5 minutes for shower, 10 minutes, 5 minutes dress up, 10 minutes have quickly breakfast and run. By 7:30, 7:45, if you are outside, you take 10 minutes to reach to school. Okay, so even if you leave your house at 8 o'clock, by 8:15 you are at school. 10 minutes. So 1 hour for you to dress up and pack your bag and everything, and then 10 minutes to reach the school. But some people who are staying far away, is it possible for them? If you are staying at Vadagara and if you have to reach St. Joseph's, is it possible for you to wake up at 7 o'clock? No, you have to wake up early. You have to catch the time, probably like 35-40 minutes traveling. Then I need time, I need to brush my teeth, I need to take shower, I need to get ready. So probably half an hour for that, right? Half an hour, 45 minutes for that separately. So you have 6 o'clock. Then you have to go out. You have to like whatever, if you have to get ready, everything. So you have to wake up probably at 5 o'clock, probably. So that you can get ready, have your breakfast, pack your bag. Probably you will leave the house at 7 o'clock. So that if there is some traffic and all, you cannot say anything. So probably you will leave the house by 7:15 so that you have enough time to travel, so that by 8 o'clock you are at school, right? So people who are traveling or staying far away, they have to wake up more early. So he says that waking up early is such an idiotic idea. It is a very funny idea, right? So he is just, now his thoughts are, you know, he is expressing his thoughts about his job. A man must have his sleep. If I didn't hold back for my parents' sake, I would have quit ages ago. Now he's saying, a man needs sleep. A human being needs sleep. Waking up so early and running around is such a funny idea, such a wrong idea. So he says, I would have quit this job years back if it was not my parents' sake. So this man, he was working, probably he had parents at home, nobody else, so he had to work. He has to learn his bread and butter, right? He has to earn his livelihood. So probably parents are at home, so he has to earn his livelihood. He has to make some money so that he can take care of his parents and the house expenses and all that stuff, right? So he says that if it would not be for my parents, I would have left this job. I would have quit this job long ago. Ages ago. Ages means years ago, I would have quit this job. I wouldn't have continued with this job if I didn't hold back for my parents' sake. Okay, I would have quit years ago. I would have gone to the boss and told him just what I think from the bottom of my heart. He said I would have frankly gone and told the boss what I really feel from the bottom of my heart, means from the core of my heart. What I feel from the core of my heart means what is my real opinion about my boss. Okay, what I actually think about my boss, I would have gone and spoken it straight on his face if I would have not needed this job. He would have fallen right off his desk. He said, if I tell my boss how I feel about him, he would have just fallen off his desk. It's a way of saying like he would have felt so bad. It is a way of saying. So he's saying that if I would have told my boss what I really feel about him, he would have felt so bad. What I feel about him, probably he didn't like the way his boss was behaving. Now, his boss used to look down upon people and talk that way. Look down upon somebody means what? You feel that complex. You say, oh, you have to do this. Oh, you are not good at this. You are not doing the job properly. However good you will be the person, some people have that habit of looking down at people and talking. Looking down means they will not appreciate what the person does. They will always have a complaining attitude. They will always find faults. They will always criticize the people. Complain, criticize, find faults. Right? So, children, these are different words. When you are writing the answers also, sometimes you can use different vocabulary so that your answer will sound better. Okay. So, he says that he would have fallen off the desk. How weird it is to sit up at the desk and talk down to an employee from way up there. So he says, how bad it is, how weird it is that you just sit up in a chair and you look down at the person, an employee from up there. Like how you talk ill about the person just sitting on your chair who is roaming around day and night, traveling, tired. How you just talk ill about that person, weird person, right? The boss is hard of hearing. So an employee has to step up quite close to him. So he says, now he is saying that the boss is hard of hearing. Hard of hearing means he is not able to hear properly. So the person who is talking to him has to go closer to him and speak loudly so that he can listen to what we are saying. Probably he needs a hearing aid, right? People who can't hear properly, what do they wear? They wear a hearing aid so that it can help with the sounds, you know. What the hearing aid will do is, it will, if anybody is talking around you, you can adjust it and it will bring the sounds. Suppose when you have a problem listening, you feel that the person is talking from far away, right? So this hearing aid, what it will do is, it will help to bring the sounds closer to your eardrum so that you can hear properly. Anyway, I haven't completely given up that hope yet. Once I've got together the money to pay off the parents' debt to him, that should take another 5 or 6 years. I'll do that for sure. I'll do it for sure. Then I'll make a big break. In any case, right now I have to get up. My train leaves at 5 o'clock. So he says that he stuck to this job only because his parents had borrowed, debt him. Means the parents had borrowed some money from this man, the boss. And they have to pay it back, of course, right? So since they couldn't pay it back, this person was working and finishing the loan. So now he's saying that he wanted to tell straight on the boss's face, but he can't able to do that since he needs to pay off the loan, which will still take another 5 to 6 years. So there is some time, but he says that once he's paid off the loan, for sure that day he's going to go up and tell the boss straight on his face. And then he's going to have a big break. But Now, coming back to reality, now he is in his thoughts, right? But coming back to reality, he says, now I need to wake up because I need to get ready and my train is at 5 o'clock. Okay. Okay, Sharon. Now we come to our third question. My third question is, my question is, what were the difficulties Greg faced during his job? Like we discussed, right? That he was worried about the train connections and the irregular food habits and all that stuff. So you have to tell all that. So my question is now, what were the difficulties Greg faced about his job? So you have to write all the answers and then send it to me in the Google Classroom. Okay, children. So we stop the chapter over here and the remaining we will continue in the next video. Okay, children. Bye.